It's Dave and Len here. We just played Walking Dead All Out War, the solitaire starter set. It's Prelude to Woodbury. I've had this for a few years now, and I finally got a chance to try it. I played all three scenarios solo last night at my house, so I brought it over here today. And Len played all three scenarios solo. I really like the game. I've had this for a few years in my collection and didn't do anything with it. I wish I would have tried it right away because this is a good one. I might get other stuff from this series. What'd you think of it, Len?
Actually, it was a lot of fun. I mean, I think we played only an hour's worth and we got three scenarios in. I mean, it's like it takes about minutes to set up. The rules are very simple, but there's a lot of like flexibility, and yes, there's cards, but the cards seem to add something to it.
Yeah, they do the random events, and there's like a threat level and stuff, and making noise or doing melee shooting, that type of stuff increases the threat level, and sometimes an event card, as soon as you pick up the card, it will increase the threat level, and then there's like a low, medium, and a high threat level, I think are the names of them, and each card, depending on what threat level you're at, determines what happens. So if you're at a lower threat level, less bad things are going to happen to you, and maybe nothing bad, where if you're at a high threat level, bad stuff's going to happen.
Yeah, because I like that the threat level is like a limit on how far. Otherwise, you'd be spending all the day doing sneak movement.
Mm-hmm.
And occasionally, you have to run. Of course, the first two scenarios, it seemed like I picked the wrong moment to run. Because once you do, all the zombies in the local area come towards you.
Well, when you run within 10 inches of you, one of them runs towards you. Whereas if you have mayhem from like shooting, then everything within 10 inches runs towards you.
Yeah. Because it wasn't until I got my pistol that I was able to handle these zombies.
Mm-hmm.
But it was still tough. And the third scenario, I finally won, but like virtually the last turn. I only had like one or two points from the maximum level.
I had a better success. I think when I played this on my own, I lost the first two scenarios, but I won the third. And the thing is, in the rule book, it says the third scenario is actually the most difficult. I thought it was the easiest. In the third scenario, what you're doing is you have to knock down zombies, get in melee with them or whatever, and knock them down and drag them to your truck and throw them in the back of your truck. And there's like, I think it starts with four zombies on the board, but if you get an event card that adds new zombies, then you got five that you got to put in your trunk. But the good thing about it is once they're in, this only has five zombies total, the starter set. So once you got like three of them in the truck, there's only two zombies you have to deal with. What makes this game challenging at times is when you're attacked by more than one zombie, instead of having like, let's say you're attacked by three zombies, instead of being attacked with three dice, it's like, I forget the number, I think it's like six or something, so it kind of like adds up.
More.
And if you're getting attacked by five zombies, they roll 15 dice, so you're basically you're gonna die if that happens. So
even you have bandages, it reduces one wound.
True. Well, a bandage will get rid of one wound. You have to spend it as an action.
You got like about 10, 12 of them. Well, you have no chance.
Yeah. But the miniatures in this, they're pretty good. They're not the best miniatures I've seen, but they're more than good enough. For plastic miniatures, I think they're, I consider them good for plastic miniatures. They're not as good as metal miniatures or like Games Workshop miniatures, but for like plastic miniatures, they're inexpensive. They look good and they got enough detail, whereas if you paint them up, I'm sure they're going to look good.
Yeah,
so that's good.
If you feel like it, you probably get metal versions of all these characters somewhere.
Right, this company doesn't have metal versions, but who knows if someone's got like a knockoff or something somewhere. But
every comic book series has models of the characters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So next Comic-Con, you could probably see them.
Yeah, and the characters in this, they look like the comic book characters. They don't look like the character, even though they're the same names generally as the ones in the TV series. They don't have the faces of the ones in the TV series, which is probably to avoid having to pay a second royalty to the actor or something, but I don't blame them for using the comic book faces instead. But overall, I thought it was really good for an inexpensive starter game, and it's solitaire, which makes it even better, yeah. So you can play it whenever you want. So
yeah.
I definitely recommend it. If you see it, even if it's at retail price, pick it up. It's worth whatever they're charging.
Yeah, because this is definitely highly rated. Easy to get started, easy to play, and still has enough quirks in it that it'll be, each time you play it, there's going to be a challenge.
Yeah.
Like the one where the car alarm went off, and I happened to be between the zombies and the car. I didn't last long. if I had been in a different location, they would all went there, and I would have been free to do what I wanted.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll have a new review. And not next week. I got to go to a convention next week, but in 2 weeks. Have a good evening.